Hey everyone, how's it going? So I just watched The Walking Dead World Beyond episode 3 and I have a lot of thoughts on this episode. I do have a Rick Grimes video coming out right after this. It's a pretty huge video. We now know for the most part Rick Grimes' location. Like, we know where he's at. We have a lot of backstory to just the character and I guess the Rick Grimes movie in general. So expect that video to come out within the next hour for sure, because we learned a lot of information on that. If you are new here and you want that video or more Walking to content as we build to this Rick Grimes movie, just make sure to be a subscriber. I also do have to warn you guys all for spoilers for tonight's episode. It was a great episode. It really was a great episode. A huge improvement over last week's. Last week's episode could have been just one of those episodes. You know, we got no CRM stuff. And even tonight, we did get some, which was obviously really exciting. But it was the stuff that happened beforehand, too, that was also not that bad. It was actually pretty good. So, yeah, obviously this will contain spoilers for all that. But let's just jump into this episode. So, Silas is my favorite character now on this show. I'm sorry, Hope. He has a pretty crazy backstory. And he's like this monster, you know. And I think that's what's kind of amazing about this character, is that he's done some very bad things. And people, just like those high school kids in the episode, they viewed him as a monster. Like, they viewed him as a murderer and just all of that, which is pretty crazy, because in that, it's the same world, but just such a different reality. Like, imagine what they would think Rick was if Rick went in there. Like, you know, and I think the actor's performance as this character tonight, and just how they executed a lot of that. He's just my favorite character. And a lot of it is because he has such a pretty messed up and just, you know, like horror-like backstory. He kind of reminds me of like a slasher character a little bit. Like, I guess like Michael Myers. I'm talking about the 2007 Rob Zombie Halloween. He kind of looks similar to that kid, obviously just more grown up, but it's the same kind of vibe. There's like this violent backstory. Obviously he's not as crazy as Michael Myers was when he was a kid, but you never know. He said he's scared of himself. Like, we could see a very dark Silas at some point. And I think this was, like, Felix in last week's episode, we got some really great backstory to that character, but nothing that really set up stuff for the future and things that could happen, because it was just more personal life stuff, right? And we saw some of the trauma that he went through, and that definitely adds to his character, and I do really like him as a character. It's just there's nothing there that we have to kind of worry about, or there's nothing there that could affect the story later on. With Silas, he has a pretty traumatic backstory as well, or childhood as well, but it's something that I guess he could just snap at some point in the future and do something pretty violent like that. I don't know. It seems like he's very calm, he's very nice, but when he's angry, he's angry. Like, there's no stopping that. And I think that's what he's scared. Like, he is literally the Incredible Hulk. That's probably a better comparison than Michael Myers. Especially when he was holding that fence up with all the tires and stuff. Like, Jesus. I don't even know if I could do that. Oh, maybe. I don't know. I'm trying to think, like, how many tires were there? Like, man, that kid's tough. So, yeah, Silas is just my favorite character right now. The characters are getting a lot better. They definitely are fitting in right. Elton, I still can't really place him anywhere. Because we know some stuff about his mom, and there's some tension there between Elton's mom and Hope and all of that. But we still don't know that much about that character. So I look forward to the next episodes, because I'm sure we're going to learn a lot more about that character. And also Iris, too. I mean, I think the thing about Iris is that we know her backstory already. And so you kind of have to choose. Do you like Iris or do you like Hope? And I like Hope more. Hope is more of I guess, rebellious. She's more on her own. She's more like Daryl. She's just more interesting. You know, Iris. Jesus Christ, they have such similar names. Iris is just like the goody two shoes in Skull. You know, those characters, I never find that interesting. And so we'll see. Obviously, characters can get more complex. They could do a lot more with her. You know, she's like the goody two shoes right now. But maybe something happens in the future where she, you know, gets all crazy. Like, because Rick in the beginning, he was also, I mean, he wasn't like goody two shoes, but kind of, you know, and look what happened to him throughout the series, you know, so things could change for these characters. But my favorites right now, the characters that I actually am watching for, are like number one, Silas, number two, Hope. And then I guess Felix would be number three. I'm not really watching for him yet, but I like him as a character. You know, he's not a boring character. So yeah, the show 3 episodes in has done really great with building up these characters. And speaking of Felix, he and Hook found the group. And I was so happy when it happened, because I didn't want that storyline to be stretched out until the end of season 1. I wanted them to find these characters pretty fast. and just go and do something else with it. Not have it 5 or 6 episodes of these characters splitting up and going on these emotional journeys and eventually by the end of the season, meeting up or something like that. Even Hope, yeah, she left in last week's episode, but it was kind of for a purpose because they wanted to escape the Blaze of Glory, this and that. And speaking of Hope, we did get some pretty amazing scenes in here. Now, I will say, first of all, that there's a lot of cringy and sappy stuff between Hope and Iris that it might just be me. It might not be have anything to do with the show, but there's just elements to that where I just think they're being too sappy. It's too emotional, I think, is what it is. It makes me sick sometimes. It's just like, oh my God, okay, enough already. Like, again, that could just be me, but there's just sometimes those scenes it's just a little too much. But the last scene, that was a good scene. That was a really great scene. You know, like that scene on the dock, Hope tells Iris about her mom and that she was the reason that her mom died. Iris seemed to be pretty upset about it, but obviously, like she says, like they were kids. And we weren't supposed to be in this situation. So obviously she forgave her. But I like that. Like, this was stuff that they set up in the premiere. Stuff that they kind of set up in episode 2. And we already got payoff with that. I think that's a good sign for the type of storytelling that they're doing here. Is that they're setting up stuff and then paying it off within an episode or two. We don't have to wait until the end of the season for things to be revealed like that. Like, they will get to it right away. And just where it makes sense anyways. Because Hope really wants to find her dad. Because the last time that they were with each other, they had this big fight. And then obviously Hope tells Iris her big secret about their mom and stuff like that. It's just, I think with all the character stuff, it actually worked really well. And I don't blame them for episode 2. I still don't like the episode. But because of how much I enjoyed tonight's episode, I can see the transition, right? The first episode, they leave. The second episode is a shock. And like, yeah, it is like How to Kill a Walker, you know, because that's the main threat there. It's just, maybe this episode should have been a little more a part of episode 2. Again, I think just sometimes you're going to have weaker episodes, right? Like, sometimes those episodes are just going to be boring, but you got to put that character stuff in there, and we might not like it, but it will build to something, which it did. Like at this point now, I feel like I really know these characters. And like, I remember all of their names now. So, but then Hope fixes a siren, and then they all escape the Blaze of Glory. And then, at that point there, Felix wants to head back. And then the group says, no, we want to keep going. And then Felix and Huck are just stuck with them, I guess, right? Because they really gave him and Huck no choice. So I also wanted to add this in here really quick. But are Silas and Iris dating? Because, like, he put his arm around her and they had, like, that blanket or hoodie or something around each other. So I'm wondering if they're dating now. And, yeah, I couldn't really tell from that scene. If you guys have watched any behind-the-scenes stuff, just comment down below, let me know. But let's talk about the ending scene, because I know that's why everyone's watching right now. So the CRM, holy shit, she's living in this city, or Elizabeth Kublik is. Elizabeth Kublik is living in a city in an apartment, and this has to be the place that Rick is in. And this is what I will be talking about later on in my video coming up within the hour. I want to go more in depth here, but we learned a lot of information here. This place is pretty civil. It's like a real society. There's like a real culture. It's just, it's practically like any city in the real world right now. We heard a helicopter fly over. We saw what it looked like through, like, out that window there. And like Elizabeth Kublik said, they have energy, water, medicine, transport, culture, agriculture. She went on and on and on about stuff that they have there. It's just, it's like the our world right now. It's like the apocalypse never happened there. Now, what happens here is that the soldier's feeling really, really bad about what happened in the end of episode 1, and doesn't believe that the place, or I guess that place that Hope and Iris are from, would have really been a threat. But I guess it really was what Iris was saying about all of that, like just her commenting on how, you know, we don't know much about the Civil Republic and all this and that, but I guess they are a threat. Anyone that is just a little threatening, anything that just opposes their ideas, anything like that, they are a threat. It seems like the CRM are very strict. Any form of like concern or worry, they will eliminate you, right? It really is as simple as that. And this seems to affect Elizabeth Kublik quite a bit, or Colonel Elizabeth Kublik, because she starts crying at the end. You know, these things have affected her. I think she's living alone now in this apartment. She really has no relationship with anyone else because of all of this. And I just realized that this is probably something that the movies will explore, which is you have to, like, yeah, you have to survive, and we are fighting for our survival, but at what cost, right? Like Elizabeth Kublik, she's surviving, but she's alone. She's killing people, right? There's a lot of terrible things about her job that she hates. So is it worth it? Are you really surviving? Are you really alive? And I think that's something that they could definitely explore. Something that Rick could bring into the CRM and all that. But the soldier goes to the CRM health and welfare complex, and we'll just have to wait and see what happens with that. I hope we see this character again, because it'll be kind of cool to learn more about this. But yeah, we'll have to wait and see. We'll have to wait and see where this story goes. I can't wait for episode 4, and I am very invested in this series now. Like, I was willing to watch the series and review every episode because of all the hype for the Rick movie. But after this last scene, I'm actually, what I will continue watching, because there's probably going to be a lot more scenes like this, and I can't wait to see what we're going to get. Like, there is an actual purpose for this show after all, I guess is what I would say. So overall, tonight's episode was a pretty good episode. Like, the stuff that happened earlier wasn't like amazing character work and stuff. It was good, but the ending really was amazing, and I haven't seen a scene like that in a very long time. Like, that scene right there beats a lot of things that happened in the Walking Dead season 10 finale for me, besides like the beta and, or not the beta stuff, but the Commonwealth at the end and all of that. Like, that scene was just, it was so exciting. And again, I think it's because it's just connected to Rick. But great episode tonight. I look forward to episode 4. So post all your thoughts down below. Hope you all enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.